Officials and businessmen from the region went to China, where they signed a memorandum of understanding for the establishment of the joint economic venture between the governments of Ninxia Hui Autonomous Region and the Volta Region of Ghana. The arrangement is the first of its kind in sub-Saharan Africa. The signing of the Sister Cities Relation Agreement of Intent now paves the way for the commencement of the establishment of an estimated 500 million yuan, about 100 million Ghana cedis, integrated agriculture and animal husbandry project in the region. The project is expected to create more than 3,000 direct and indirect job opportunities in the region. The Volta Regional Minister, Joseph Amenawode, signed on behalf of the government of Ghana and the region, while the Chinese ambassador to Ghana, Gong Jianzong, also signed on behalf of Ninxia State Province. Mr. Amenawode expressed gratitude to the Chinese government for its assistance to Ghana's developmental agenda.
This is MCE's and the Volta Regional Coordinating Council is ever prepared to support any scheme individually by any chief of traditional area or collectively by the Volta Region House of Chiefs. We can only move forward if we remain partners. I want to thank Mamaga Akosua. I want to thank them especially for their sponsorship.
The president of the Volta Regional House of Chiefs, Togbe Afede, is the main architect of the project.
We believe government is a shared responsibility. So rather than sit and watch our people fight for limited resources, we have a commitment to helping the central government to expand available resources and opportunities.
The Chinese ambassador to Ghana, Gong Jianzong, said both Ghana and China are developing countries and that there is the need for more cooperation for mutual benefit. It is the expectations of both parties that this would further strengthen existing bilateral trade and communication links between the people of Ghana and China, as a government delegation from Ninxia is expected to visit the Volta region in February next year.